speak to Cheah, founder and chairman of Sunday Group. Hi, how are you, Steph?
How are you?
Gentlemen, the Monash Chamber Orchestra. Yang Berhormat, Dato Sri Dr. S. Subramaniam, Minister of Health, Malaysia. His Excellency, Mr. Rod Smith, PSM, High Commissioner of Australia to Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia, Tan Sri Dato Sri Dr. Jeffrey Cheah, AO, founder and chairman, Sunway Group. And Chairman, Monash University, Malaysia. Professor Andrew Walker, President and Pro Vice Chancellor, Monash University, Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia, Tan Sri Datuk Sri Razman M. Hashim, Member of Board, Monash University, Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia, Tan Sri Datuk Sri Ramon Navaratnam, Member of Board, Monash University, Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia, Tan Sri Datuk Lin Siyan, Member of the Board, Monash University, Malaysia. Professor Christina Mitchell, Dean, Faculty of Medicine, Nursing and Health Sciences, Monash University. Dr. Lee Wing King, Chief Executive Officer, Education and Healthcare Division, Sunway Group. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, welcome to our 10th anniversary celebrations of the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences, Monash University, Malaysia. I'm Maud Phipps and I'm honoured to be your MC for this evening. This year marks a most significant milestone in the development of medical education in Malaysia, as we recognise and celebrate the establishment and development and future aspirations of an internationally top-ranked medical school in Malaysia. We are honoured to have with us distinguished guests who include prominent alumni at that table, and this too, and who have journeyed with the school and in their own way contributed to the many achievements that the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences has made and continues to make in our country and in the region. We have a full program for you this evening, organized by our very hard-working program organizing committee, led by our head, Dr. Sharp. And I would like to recognize also the efforts of the students of Monash University, Malaysia, who will be showcasing their talent as the evening progresses. We are honored that the Honorable Minister has made the time to be with us this evening to launch two publications produced in conjunction with the 10th anniversary. These are, firstly, Celebrating 10 Years of Quality Medical Education in Malaysia, which was produced by the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences, and secondly, On Becoming a Doctor, which was produced by the alumni of the school, now who are Monash trained doctors, and I believe doing a very fine job. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming the head of the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences, Professor Shah Jahan Yassin, to deliver his welcoming address.
Yang Berhormat, Dato' Sri Dr. S. Subramaniam, Minister of Health of Malaysia, His Excellency Mr. Rod Smith, Australian High Commissioner to Malaysia, Tan Sri Yang Bahagia, Tan Sri Dato' Sri Jeffrey Cheah, Chairman of the Board, Monash University Malaysia, and Founder and Chairman of Sunway Group, Professor Andrew Walker, President and Pro Vice Chancellor, Monash University, Malaysia. Professor Christina Mitchell, Dean, Faculty of Medicine, Nursing and Health Sciences, Monash University. Professor Michelle Leach, Deputy Dean, MBBS Faculty of Medicine, Nursing and Health Sciences, Monash University. Dato Sri Lee Si Yang, a board member of Monash University, Malaysia. Tan Sri Razman and Tan Sri Ramon Navaratnam, and Dr. Lee Wen Keng, as well as Dr. Elizabeth Lee. Welcome for this session, and thank you for attending this 10th anniversary celebration. The distinguished guests, staff, alumni, and students of Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences, I would like to a little bit reflect on how we have gone, where we started, and then where we hopefully a little bit about where we hope to go. As I reflect over the last 10 years, we had initially three recruits. I was one of the first few, but the real people who made this school was the foundation head of the school, Professor Dr. Anwar Zaini, who was previously the Dean of University Malaya Medical School, as well as the Vice Chancellor of University Malaya. The second person is the head of the clinical school in Johor Bahru, Professor Dato Khalil Kadir, who was a Monash alumni and who has spent more than 10 years after graduation in Australia, working and then completing his PhD, doing his specialist degree, and then returning as the head of UKM Medical School before joining us in 2005. When you think about it, when you have such a distinguished and experienced leaders, there is little chance that the venture we started out to do would not do well. And when I look back, I'm actually surprised at what I've achieved, what we have as a team achieved. If you could indulge me a few minutes, I would like to relate some of these achievements. To date, the Jeffrey Cheah School has graduated 600 students. The graduates who have graduated are working in Australia and Malaysia and are extremely well regarded by the clinical specialists and the clinical consultants where they work. Our entry criteria remains one of the highest among private schools in this country. We have got accreditation in a number of countries, including Sri Lanka, Thailand, and most importantly, Australia. The Australian Medical Council recognition, which came almost from the beginning, was on the basis that students and graduates from this school were of equal standard to those in Australia. Our medical students have performed extremely well in over the years, and in a number of years, they have been actually the top performers across the whole program. The medical community, I think, considers the program as one of the best in this country. 20% of our students, our current students, have got parents and relatives who are doctors. Our current students and graduates actually vote the confidence in the program by encouraging siblings, cousins, relatives to enroll into the program, and we have a large number of those. Nearly a third of our graduates are currently working in Australia, and many of them have started postgraduate training. Some of them have completed the postgraduate training, and a number of them are now coming back to serve in Malaysia. But I think one of the biggest impact is in the area of research. For a private university, in the area of research, we have a very strong research interest in non-communicable disease, especially in diabetes and obesity. We also have a strong interest in infectious disease, especially in dengue infections. There's significant research in bioactive compounds, drug discovery, cancer research. We have the latest LC-MS equipment. We have the bioimaging facility. We have an extremely well-regarded and very active clinical trial center at Sunway as well as in Johor Bahru. our Southeast Asian Community Observatory platform, which is based in Sakabat, is very active in doing public health research. The Brain Research Institute at Monash Sunway has been doing some very high-level work in the area of neuroscience. In terms of output, we have more than 800 Scopus publications, and some of the publications are in Nature, in The Lancet, and in JAMA. We have graduated more than 40 PhD students, currently we have almost 95 PhD students currently enrolled. We have more than 10 million ringgit in external international funding. This is all done over a period of less than 5 years, because research started about three years after the school started, really. So it is important to remember the scale of those achievements over the last 10 years. But these achievements are due to the determination, encouragement, and commitment of our chairman, Tan Sri Dato Sri Jeffrey Cheah, who had a single-minded purpose to make the school one of the best in the country and the region. He had funded the school over the last 10 years as we went about building the school. I must say we are now in a much better financial footing compared to five, 6 years ago. These achievements are all documented in greater detail in the anniversary book that's been produced and is being launched today, and all of you all would get a copy of it and you can look at it in greater detail. So allow me to spend a few minutes to look into the future. The medical and healthcare environment has become more challenging over the last 10 years, I think we can all agree. There are more medical schools have opened up. Together we are producing a lot more doctors. The hospitals and clinical training centers are getting quite crowded. Almost all medical schools are finding some difficulty in finding academic staff. Waiting periods for housemanship are significantly increased. Postgraduate training places has not increased or kept pace with this increase in the doctor output. And this is all happening in our country, in an environment with significant healthcare challenges. There's an explosion of NCDs, and over the years, we have an unenviable distinction of having the largest prevalence of diabetes and obesity in the region. Public health systems, which have been initially developed to deal with infectious disease and maternal and child health issues, are straining to deal with effectively with these problems. For a university and a medical school to be relevant, it needs to directly engage with these issues. So where do we go from here? Where will we be 10 years from now? Peter Drucker, an eminent management expert, said the best way to predict the future is to create it. You know, I think we want to be in that space. Having spent so much time building a top medical school, the next stage will be to become part of the solution to some of these problems that I have enumerated earlier. In that sense, I must say Tan Sri Jeffrey Cheah has been again very prescient. He has having developed top educational and healthcare facilities in the Sunway City, he now talks about wanting to make Sunway City into a smart city. In his usual single-minded commitment towards this, he has brought the Jeffrey Sachs Sustainability Institute to Sunway. He has started an international symposium series. Last year it was in precision medicine, and this year it's going to be in stem cell in November. He has been discussing with top universities like Harvard, Cambridge, and Oxford to help contribute towards the vision, towards this vision. I would like to end by what I see. I believe, however, some of these top universities, when they come in, Jeffrey Cheah School will be both a contributor to as well as a beneficiary of these endeavors. We will be engaging with all these centers, all these universities in a full way. I'd like to I'd like to see what we would be 10 years from now, you know, a little bit of gazing into the future, if you like. I think in 10 years' time, we will be much better integrated in the community we are located in, this place, in Sunway City, and the region around this. We'll be doing this by trialing a number of innovations in healthcare education as well as healthcare delivery. We plan to lead an interprofessional education, and this will be based on the fact that doctors alone are not going to solve some of the healthcare challenges that we face currently. With that in mind, we hope to start at least two or three new programs over the next year, next 2 years. We will be in the postgraduate training space, either through a master's program or training towards exit specialist degrees like the MRCP or MRCS, or probably in both of these spaces. We are already pioneers in using private hospitals like Sunway Medical Center for teaching. This, I hope, will expand, and we will make we will be very much involved in getting the Sunway Medical Center into a highly research focused hospital. In an environment where the biggest problems are NCDs, teaching and research has to move away from primarily hospital environments into the community and community clinics. In this country, we have one of the best healthcare systems in the world. We have a large number of private general practitioners and private specialist practices, and these resources are not adequately used for teaching or learning and for testing new approaches to innovations and learning. The Sunway City would be an ideal environment to test these approaches and these innovations. With Tansi's inspiration, I'm confident it will get there. I'd like to end by acknowledging and thanking the faculty. Professor Chris Mitchell has been an inspiration, a very, very strong supporter of the school. I'd like to also thank Professor Michelle Leach, who looks after the medical program, for her engagement with us, the responsibility she has given us, and the trust she has placed on us. And finally, I'd like to thank Professor Andrew Walker, who is of a new PVC, and he has been a bit of a breath of fresh air, if I can say so, and has been engaging with Sunway University and Sunway Medical Center in a big way. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Cheah. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Dean of the Faculty of Medicine, Nursing and Health Sciences, Monash University, Professor Christina Mitchell.
Smith, Australian High Commissioner to Malaysia, colleagues and friends. It is a great pleasure and honour to be here tonight to celebrate this great 10th birthday party of the Geoffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences. Geoffrey Cheah and the then VC of Monash University, Richard Larkins, had the great vision to start a medical school in Malaysia in 2007. And many people said it couldn't be done. It was a risky business, but great leaders are prepared to take risks for great, grand adventures. Their vision has been validated and has been an enormous success. The medical school is training the leaders of medicine and health, both in Malaysia, but also Australia, Sri Lanka, and Asia. These are our top medical leaders and graduates who are going to make a huge difference. Geoffrey Cheah has left a lasting legacy in human capital. The greatest capital you can have is in humans and their leadership and what they can develop. It outlasts bricks and mortars. The medical graduates from the Geoffrey Cheah School frequently outperform their Australian counterparts exams in both undergraduate and more recently in specialist exams. The Australian Medical Council recently reviewed the Geoffrey Cheah Medical School. Not only did they give us an outstanding report, the thing that they were most affected by was that the medical students were so proud to be enrolled in the Geoffrey Cheah Medical School. They wear that with a badge of honour. And so you should be extremely proud that your students feel this way about this medical school. It's due to its extremely high standards, its research-intensive focus, and most importantly, its international outlook. This success can be attributed to the great teachers, to the great leaders such as Anwar Zani and Professor Shah Jasmine and many others, and because the vision has been fulfilled. It should be noted that the relationship between Monash University of Malaysia and Monash Australian Medical School, even from the outset, is not just one of cordial partnership, it's more than that. We are one family that has developed curricula, organised exams, and work together that brings something unique to our joint programs. There is one curricula, one program, and we are one community of medical researchers, educators, and physicians. So what to the future of education? Can we work together on more educational programs? One of the great challenges we all face in our society is ageing, and the need for physiotherapists, social workers, occupational therapists to match the challenges of the age, which is our ageing communities. Can we develop joint educational and research programs in these areas? We've already started discussing these possibilities. We have some of the top professional courses in these disciplines at Monash University Australia. What to the future of medical research? Geoffrey Cheah has recognised by his investment in universities and medical education that human capital is the greatest legacy. So can we build medical research together with Harvard and Cambridge and Oxford and Monash University to address the grand challenges of our age, which include precision medicine, ageing, genomics, diabetes and obesity, that are significant problems for both our nations, both Malaysia and Australia? One way I think we can do this is by harnessing your and our medical graduates to become Malaysia's clinical and medical researchers of the future, as exemplified by the PhD scholarship programs that Geoffrey Cheah Foundation is funding. We need to extend that to get the Monash Malaysia medical students to do PhDs as well, to become the clinician scientists of the future. So finally, it only remains to thank all the staff, students, and to congratulate them on their success, and to wish the school a very happy 10th birthday, and I look forward to the next decade of continued success. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have kept you waiting for long enough. I'm happy to announce that dinner will now be served. Please enjoy the hospitality of the Sunway Resort Hotel and Spa. Enjoy. I trust you have enjoyed your starters, ladies and gentlemen. The Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences would not have been realized if not for the vision of one individual. Tan Sri Dato Sri Dr. Jeffrey Cheah has recently returned from a trip to New York, where he received a standing ovation at his inaugural address to the Leadership Council of the United Nations Sustainable Development Solutions Network meeting, where he shared his views on the importance of sustainable development that will impact on all sectors of society in this part of the world. We commend Tan Sri for championing the sustainable development agenda. Please join me now in giving a very warm welcome to Tan Sri Datuk Sri Dr. Jeffrey Cheah on stage to deliver his address.
Yang Berhormat Datuk Sri Dr. S. Subramaniam, Minister of Health, Malaysia, Your Excellency Ross Smith, Professor Christine Mitchell, Dean of Monash University Medical School, my fellow colleagues, staff, alumni, and students of Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and welcome to Sunway City. I am delighted that all of you can join us in celebrating the 10th anniversary of the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences at Monash University, Malaysia. Monash University, Malaysia was established in 1998 as the first foreign university campus in Malaysia. It was also Monash University's first campus outside of Australia and was established as a joint partnership with the Jeffrey Cheah Education Group. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish to maybe tell you about the journey of Monash University, Malaysia, here. Now, I started Sunway College I formed Sunway College in 1986 and went into accepting student in 1987. Right from the start, I have always looked for a medical school. In the late 80s, I got Leicester University, who was our twinning partners then, to organize a luncheon with three dean of medicine Churchill Hotel. I can remember that very clearly. Actually, I wanted to talk to them to have a twinning degree in medicine from the UK. We had a lot of deliberation, and finally they convinced me. He said, Jeffrey, it's not possible because it's so difficult to get the General Medical Council to accept or to recognize that twinning degree. So I said, okay. That's one gone. And so, never mind. Then we had training programs with Monash University. And when Dato' Sri Najib was Minister of Education, he opened up Malaysia for foreign university campus. Of course, I worked very hard to get Monash here. And of course, they gave two licenses. One is Monash and one is Nottingham. Nottingham, of course, is his alma mater. But anyway, I told him that Monash is a very good university, and he said, yes, good, you can. I will give an invitation to Monash. That's the act. The minister must give
an invitation letter to Monash University to open the branch campus here. And that's how it started. And when that happened, I got the then Vice Chancellor, Professor Mel Logan, who was given this letter to open the branch campus here. Of course, he know me well and all this. After that letter was issued to him, he went around to check me out and also at the same time to look if he can find a better partner than Jeffrey Cheah. But anyway, he did that and he came back, he said, oh, Jeffrey, you are still the best partner, let's shake hands and do it. So okay, that's how we started the Monash campus here. And I have told him, Mel, okay, you can do engineering, liberal arts, and all this degree is well regarded, Monash University, but I want your medical school. He looked at me, he said, Jeffrey, don't even dream of it. I said, why? No, first, there are three things. First thing is that it's very expensive. I don't think you can afford it. And secondly, he said, so difficult, I don't think I can convince the Australian Medical Council, Australian and New Zealand Medical Council to agree to recognize an offshore degree from Monash. And thirdly, my problem is the Monash Council won't approve it. You know, I said, why? You have no confidence. No, it's not me, I'm entrepreneurial like you, but you know, to convince the academic is almost impossible. So anyway, that's it. Then finally, we formed the branch campus here, and you know, Monash only wanted to take 20% of the campus here. I told Mel, don't you have any confidence in this campus? Well, maybe I have, but my people in Australia may not have. They are risk averse, you know. So we talk and talk, finally he said, okay, we take 24%. And that's the final, you know. So we took 76, we went into the joint venture, and Monash paid 1.2 million at that time. Today, of course, in royalty, they already got back 400 million. And today, Monash University is worth hundreds of million. So isn't this a good business for Monash? So that is one story, okay? So I tell you, that is the on the medical school, which I'm very passionate about, because I wanted a wholesome university with medical degree and all this. I have always wanted that. And there was a change of vice chancellor. Then came David Robinson, Professor David Robinson. I'm sure all of Christine, and I think you shake your head. What kind of a man he is, a tough man. He went and set up a campus in Johannesburg. When he told me that, I said, David, are you sure or not? You know, Johannesburg? Oh, we are confident. And they invested hundreds of million there. Hundreds of million, I think. Professor Christine is shaking her head. And as you move along, there were change of, again, the Vice Chancellor, Professor Richard Larkin. Professor Richard Larkin, of course, he is a medical doctor himself. I also talked to him about the medical school. And of course, he and Professor Appen, who was the Dean of Medicine then, was very supportive. Of course, they went and talked to the medical council, and they also talked to the Monash Council, and everything seems positive. That was very good. And there, of course, there was a business plan being done by our people. And then continue to do the study of this medical school, how much it will cost, whether I can afford or not, and all this by my people, by my own people. So anyway, finally, when all this the medical council approved, gave us the okay to go ahead, and Monash Council also said okay to go ahead, I applied for the license from the Malaysian Education Ministry. You cannot believe it. It was rejected. And I applied again a few months later, also rejected. They said there's enough doctors, enough of medical school. That was more than 10 over years ago. Now only we are talking about maybe a lot of graduates, too many doctors are graduating, but in 10 over years, they said there's enough medical school, enough for doctors. So I didn't give up. I went to see the Prime Minister then, Dr. Mahathir, and I explained to him. I said, sir, you know, it's so difficult for me to get Monash to agree, and it's very well regarded medical school. And basically, I wanted Monash here. Of course, I said that just to please him. I said, Monash here will benchmark our university here, our medical school here, to be at least, if not better, than this standard. Because Monash medical school standard can be is acceptable worldwide. So I think, you know, he listened and then I'm like, okay, okay. Then 2 weeks later, I got the license. It was very good, 3 hurdles crossed. Then Mr. Lee Wing King and my president of the group with a business plan came. He said, Tan Sri, very sorry, I don't think we can afford this medical school. He said we will lose 120 million before we even break even. Not invest, lose 120 million. Oh my God. So I said, wow, I've been through a lot to get here, no? Never mind, we will have to go in. We go in. So that's how we started Jeffrey Cheah, I mean Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine. Of course, Richard Larkin was very happy to have that. He knew how passionate I was, how determined I was to have the medical school. He decided to name it after me. I said, okay, fine. If my name is good enough, fine, you know. So he named it after me, Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine. And now it has continued very well, I must say. And of course, we were losing money, like Professor Shah just said. Monash didn't want to have any share. You see? They didn't want to have any share in it because they were so worried about that risk taking. So that's fine. We went on, and you know, after that, when we were doing quite well, Monash asked for more share. That's typical of the academic, you know. So finally, I also tell them, okay lah, because we are good partners, I will sell you another 21% and 55-45 for Monash, and that will be the last. Don't ask for any more. That's how today's structure is like. 45 Monash, 55 Sunway. Anyway, it has gone very, very well, and as you know, we have graduated hundreds of students, and today we are celebrating the 10th anniversary. I'm so proud standing here, also very humbled that we have done so well. Our students, like Professor Zah and Professor Christine say, we have even performed better than their counterpart in Australia, which is maybe Malaysian work much harder than the Australian. Now, of course, after having all that, I have to have a teaching clinical hospital, I mean for the clinical years for the student. So I went and talked to the Minister of Health then, pardon me, and a few ministers' friends to help. I wanted a hospital, teaching hospital, to be in the Klang Valley. Of course, Klang Valley has all been taken by the public hospital. So finally, they said there's one more left, you know, in Sultana Aminah Hospital in Johor Bahru. So I said, wow, that's very far. Take it or leave it, Jeffrey. So I said, okay, we sign. Because I know medical school, you need to have at least about 1,000 beds, and also must have all kinds of diseases for the student, the undergrads, to learn from. And that's we have done. And we have built a lot of facility next to Sultana Aminah, and we call it our own clinical center, which is fantastic, yeah. And that's how the medical school has come thus far, and I must thank all the good people, the team who has helped to make it work. Of course, we have to scale higher level. So I was just talking to the our colleagues in Monash that I have worked very hard to get Cambridge now. Cambridge University has decided I'm going there on the 18th to sign an agreement with Cambridge University. You will soon see this thing in Sunway Medical. Cambridge University with their logo, big logo there. School of Clinical Medicine, regional site partner, Sunway. So, this is such a good thing, but it's not bringing Cambridge to fight Monash, no. It is together with Monash, together with Sunway, we work hard to bring good cutting-edge research and hopefully patient care and what have you to Malaysia. I, together with Oxford, Harvard and Cambridge, I have always told them that it's not that I want to go to your university, but I want your people to come to Malaysia. It's very important. This is my requirement. And they have all agreed because basically Malaysia is truly Asia. You can get plenty of food, you can get, you know, it's a melting pot of culture, melting pot of race, religion, and DNA, you know, and genetic and what have you. So these are very important to this university. And of course, my commitment, they are very, very happy and so I said comfortable with my commitment. And I told them, you have my commitment. Provided you discover the gene fast to make me live longer, you know, so that I can be here to commit more. And then I have plenty of resources to make sure that it will work and it will work well. And that's how I convinced all these people. Of course, signing with Cambridge University, we are just not signing with the clinical school. We are signing with Royal Papworth Hospital, Papworth Hospital in Cambridge, and Edinburgh Hospital. Together, they have thousands of beds. And it's all Papworth Hospital, of course, we all know, is the best lung and heart hospital in Europe. You know, the two gentlemen who came over here a few weeks ago, John Warwick and Roger Hall. This John Warwick has transplanted an operation where he transplanted three organs together, lung, heart, and liver. and the patient, I was told, is still alive. It is fantastic. You know, I hope we don't have to transplant so much. You know, so I really am very impressed, but we will have a very good collaboration with them. And I told them, this place is like your home. Come, you know, during winter time, your place is so cold, it's so nice here. Come over. Professor Jala, you're laughing, I know. He has been telling them. And this is fantastic. And also, I just came back from Harvard. I went to seven universities, all the Ivy League almost. And in Harvard, because I sit in the Global Advisory Council, chaired by the president, it was very enlightening actually. And I met, out of the 12 dean they have, I met seven of them. All of them were so happy and so excited to come and have more collaborative agreement or arrangement with Sunway. And that is a great endorsement of our credibility, our commitment, our conviction for medical science. And they know that, you know, I'm for doing well by doing good. And that's very important because in the education side, all of you know that I put in the foundation and it's not for money. It's not for money in my pocket. It is for humankind. and good quality education for our future generation is most crucial for a successful and competitive, prosperous Malaysia. And these are indeed very good time, but there's a lot of work to do yet. I told Professor Christine, you cannot expect results tomorrow. Education, research is a long-term thing, but I'm prepared to do a lot to fund it, to hopefully to get funding from a lot of kind people so that we can do proper work. Now, I think the Vice Chancellor of Cambridge, Professor Boris Lysak, he did tell me that, you know, Jeffrey, you are you can be very proud, you know. Cambridge, every other week, there are suitors coming to want to collaborate with Cambridge, but we have never said yes. But after visiting you, after knowing you, my team, all together, you said our partners, corporate partners, very close collaborative partners, Harvard, Yale, and MIT. And now, Sunway, now you can be very proud, shake your hand. I said, no, I'm not proud, but I'm humbled. I'm so glad that that you all recognize our effort, our sincerity in to build a better world for humankind. So, in our Sunway Medical, Lau Ping Long has been to Harvard. We are now very keen to link with Boston Children's Hospital and Boston Women's Hospital, which we are going to establish. Lau, of course, has got a lot on his plate because now we just started with 620 beds. And I told him I want 1,100 beds, he have sleepless night. But anyway, you know how it is, it's not easy to have 1,100 beds teaching hospital. And I want to make sure I have the dream realized. When you have big dreams, of course you have nightmares, you know, but then I need to share it with other people, like Lau, you know, who will have to share it with me. And the thing, I was just talking to the minister, I said, look, I know a teaching hospital, you know, a private hospital like ours, we charge fees. And all the private patients, eventually I believe they will learn. Some of them may not want the student to touch them or to look at their files, you know. But eventually I think they'll learn. But I was talking to the minister just now, the DG, Dato Noor Hisham, has worked with us. We are going to sign an agreement with the government to send public patients. After all, the patients are already in the public hospital who are jam, long wait, you know, they can come to Sunway Hospital and so that our student can also examine and treat them. Our student will learn, because in the teaching hospital, you must have all kinds of diseases. If not, the student won't be exposed, won't learn the right thing. So I think that is something that we are working on, and I believe I want to see it happen before I go. Anyway, these are all very good endorsements. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, today we celebrate the 10th anniversary of the medical school. I'm pleased that with what has been achieved, the school is considered one of the top medical school in the region. Yeah, like I said, our student has performed, some of them has got prizes, top prizes from Monash University, and it is a real honor for all of us. The school research achievements are considerable and include the Brain Research Institute of Monash, BRIMS here, Sunway, as well as the Southeast Asia Community Observatory, SECO in short, which is based in Segama, which is our minister's constituency. Minister, I think, thank you for your support in that sense. Yeah. And we are also having a large PhD program, among the most research-intensive private medical school in the country. I hope to build and develop Sunway City as a regional hub of excellence in health, in the healthcare sector. And of course, I need all the good people to help us get there. Okay, like Monash, like you know, Christine, Ellen, and all these good people. You know, signing with Cambridge, there will be a two-way flow of experts, thought leaders, researcher, and all this, because it will be headed by a professor where we pay half of his salary, Cambridge pay half, and all this. They are very, very serious about this partnership, and it is fantastic for us, actually. Another thing is, I'm so happy that and proud, you know, the Sunway Medical a few months ago gained recognition in the region as the best, not the best, second runner-up, second, together with Mount Elizabeth Hospital for medical tourism. This is awarded by Hong Kong Travel Magazine and a big equity fund called Cheah Bernstein. And you know, the number one is of course is Promengat in Bangkok. You know, and I was telling Mr. Lau and the team, of course I'm not happy with number two. Go for number one. I think that is another big headache for him. But anyway, we share the dreams together. We should be all very proud one day. Ladies and gentlemen, in closing, let me reiterate that while we have come this far, I'm fully confident that the Jeffrey School of Medicine and Health Sciences will continue to set new benchmarks in the years ahead. I expect the school to contribute even more to advancing the state of healthcare in Malaysia and in the region. My congratulations to the team, the staff, and students of the school for what they have achieved, and I wish them the best for the future. Like I said, like the Professor Shah said, I look forward to the next 10 years with optimism and confidence. 10 years of excellent service and care for the patient. Thank you.
Thank you very much, for delivering your address. You are most inspirational. And if you look at our theme, perhaps you have been boldly where no one has gone before. It's a bit of a Star Trek theme to actually pioneer the way. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me now in welcoming our guest of honour, the Honourable Minister of Health, Yang Berhormat Dato Sri Dr. S. Subramaniam, to deliver his address.
Thank you, Master of Ceremony, and a good evening to all of you. Tan Sri Dato Sri Dr. Jeffrey Cheah, Chairman of the Board of Monash University, Founder and Chairman of Sunway Group, Professor Andrew Walker, President and Pro Vice Chancellor of Monash University, Malaysia, Dean of the Monash University in Melbourne, Professor Christina Michal, Dr. Shah, Dean of the Monash University in Malaysia, Medical University of Malaysia, members of the board, friends, ladies and gentlemen, first thank the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health for inviting me to with you to be part of these grand celebrations of the 10th anniversary of the founding of the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine. And just now we all had the opportunity of listening to the struggles and tribulations which the founders of the institute face in setting it up. And of course, now is probably the time to reap the results of those 10 years of success. And congratulate Tansri for his vision, his passion, and his steadfastness to ensure that whatever he wants to achieve is actually fully achieved. In my interactions with Tansri over the last few years, I've seen him as an entrepreneur with a different make and a different vision. And this is quite unusual for entrepreneurs, because mostly the concept of a businessman which we have is one who will probably try to squeeze every dollar out of everything which you do. And it's very unusual for a businessman to go to an international conference and speak on sustainability, whilst there are many who actually would like to rape the forests of the country to ensure that it will increase your wealth. So in that situation, that you are actually dedicated to the principles of sustainability is something which probably makes you different from other businessmen in my short interactions. I'd also like to congratulate Tansri, because he was the first brave owner of a mall in this country who actually listened to the Ministry of Health and declared it as a no-smoking mall. That is also, can be considered as a very unbusiness-like decision, where there was a signal to all smokers that if you want to smoke and come to this mall, please don't come to this mall, probably choose another one. So in that sense, I think these are brave decisions, not commonly ones which we get from business people. And the decision to invest in knowledge, which I've also seen, which increases the feeling of intellectualism, which might not directly translate into profit, but in the long term probably develops the mind, which will contribute towards the development of knowledge. Last year I had the opportunity of being part of the precision medicine seminar which was organized here, and had an opportunity to talk. And in a frontage of medicine, which we are all moving forward, it was nice to see a private university looking into an area which is probably the area in which medicine is probably going to grow in the future, and bringing people from the global fraternity to exchange their views, and allowing local medical professionals to be part of it. This is not something which we see in many of the other private schools in this country. For those who are not from Malaysia, for a population of 30 million people, we've got 33 medical schools. So one of the few countries, for every 1 million, we've got one medical school. So, and out of which 11 are in the government sector, 22 are in the private sector. And like what Dr. Cheah said in his speech just now, we actually produce 5,000 new doctors a year collectively among the 33 schools and those who go from overseas, because a lot of Malaysian children, when they are born itself, they already decided to become doctors. And you can't erase that thought from their mind, so it's so fixed. And so the leaders 20 years ago decided we will appease this desire by allowing many, many medical schools to come forth. And as a result of that, now I am actually faced with this daunting task of giving places of training for all the housemen which you are producing, because they are delayed, and how well we can solve this problem. It's a difficult problem. So in solving these issues, of course, Dr. Cheah actually enumerated all the main problems which we face in health. I thought he would also come with the solutions, and we stopped with the problems alone. Hoping that the minister will come with the solutions, which I'm not going to do either. But anyway, Tansri, I think it's good that at least you've come forward to share some of our problems. So that is something which is good, and I think this private-public relationship, which we have shunned for a long time, we've shied away from it, we were fearful of it, we thought that it would not work, We looked at each other with suspicion. I think probably the time has come to overcome the suspicions, to overcome the shyness, and see how we living together. While sitting next to Transi, he said that when you send your patients here, I said we will, but we will only pay you the cost which we are spending in the Ministry of Health. So, and he said that's possible. So if that is possible, then it's workable. But the only problem will come when you ask us to pay more than what we are spending in the Ministry of Health. So long as we are clear on the areas on which we will work, then of course we can always have workable things. So I did ask him, are you still going to give these patients who are coming a single bed? He said, no, we will make larger beds for these people so they can have 6-bedded room and 8-bedded room. I said, that's most probably the more practical thing to do for these public patients, because you need to bring down the cost, not bring down the level of treatment, but bring down the cost by cutting down the other amenities which come with it. So that is something which will be a win-win situation for the public and private sector, insofar as sharing of professionals and all that. As most of the private sector will definitely know, the entire private sector in Malaysia, including the teaching hospitals, at least to some great extent, should thank the Ministry of Health for investing and training in all these doctors, making them good specialists. After that, we contribute them to you. They come to you, and something we are trying to stop, but which we have singularly failed, and I know we continuously fail. So I've told my ministry, don't try to stop them, keep them as long as we can, and after that, if they have to go, they have to go. This is something which is not possible, but if we can share and have a long-term partnership where these experiences can benefit both the private and the public sector, then that will be in the best of the nation. So we need to identify how we can do this. And I thank Tan Sri, you are the first. I did last year offer all the private hospitals, look here, why don't you sponsor scholarships for master's program training? And after we train, we will train them well and we'll give them back to you. And very few private hospitals took forward. And you are the first private hospital who has taken that offer to sponsor 10 students for master's program. And I thank you for that. And thank you for that. And that is the first move in increasing the number of specialists in this country. Because the public services department, the custodian of scholarships, has become very, very stingy over the last few years. And they've cut down the number of scholarships available. And this reduced the opportunities for training, and we have to find newer, innovative ways of providing opportunities for our young doctors so they actually can have opportunities to train. And there are many other areas I think this cooperation can go to, so that more and more specialists can be produced, because you also have some of the top professional specialists in many areas of medicine who are now working in your setups, and they can definitely contribute back to us in terms of our in care of patients and also in training of young doctors for the future. And this is important to utilize their expertise and so that as a whole we can benefit. You see, in Malaysia, we have had this very beautiful public and private health systems which are running together. And the public system, of course, has been oversubscribed many, many, many times. And it's straining us. And even 2 days ago, I had to tell the Prime Minister that we can't go on like this, because we are going to have a budget in another 11 days' time. And of course, all ministers are wishful thinking. Prime Minister will solve all our problems. But I'm quite sure it will remain in a special thinking as it was last year and the year before. And I doubt that we will get much more money than what we ever got. But that is the basis of the economy of the country, and we cannot complain too much about it. And we have to live with what we have. But whatever said and done, it strains the system. Because as Tan Sri said, Professor Christian, we are the only country our patients come without paying anything to anybody and get lots of medicine and go back home. So, and when you have a system like that, it's of course, how long can we sustain it? It's a big issue. big issue, how we are going to sustain it. And of course, as politicians, we all like to give everything free of charge because that makes us more popular. But unfortunately, to what an extent we can stretch that, it's a very, very difficult thing. So this is important that we have this relationship between private and public, which will actually enable us to become better. And I like this 1,200 teaching hospital you are going to build. And I hope the idea of public patients coming there and being treated at the cost of the Ministry of Health and giving you the variety and diversity of cases which you want will actually realize so that you can remove some of the burdens which we face. So ladies and gentlemen, I congratulate the Jeffrey Cheah Medical School on its grand 10 years of success. And I'm sure, Tansri, you will continue to lead it for further many, many more 10 years, multiples of 10 years, I mean. And whether the geneticists find the new portion to keep you going, but with all the good things you're doing, nature will keep you going. With those words, I thank you very much.
Thank you very much, we look forward to the synergies in the future, and thank you for addressing very pertinent issues in the healthcare industry. Ladies and gentlemen, our dinner will continue until the next event. Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment, in addition to the Monash Chamber Orchestra, we have a special performance by our very talented students in Monash University. Please welcome Dance Fusion.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dance Fusion. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to call upon Tan Sri, Dato Sri Dr. Jeffrey Cheah, to join Yang Berhormat Dato Sri Dr. S. Subramaniam on the stage for the launch of two special books that were produced especially for the occasion of the 10th anniversary of the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences. Articles from our celebrated alumni and staff, celebrating the fond memories, camaraderie, and kinship that was forged during their time at the clinical school in Johor Bahru. I would like to invite our guest of honor and also our chairman and founder to launch the book, and I would like to call upon Tan Sri to present copies of both books to the Honourable Minister as our token of appreciation. At the registration table outside the hall for 25 ringgit. This is a special prize only for this event. Proceeds will go to charity.
The Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences at Monash University in Malaysia, we herald a hallmark of vision, innovation, and excellence. The vision of the founding team, the dedication of the people behind it all. Real doctors, real experiences, real expertise. Because we believe in delivering the best, world-class learning facilities, state-of-the-art training system, award-winning lecturers, even conducive environment for fun and play, prestigious accreditations from professional bodies across Malaysia, Australia, and New Zealand, strategic partnerships and engagements with industry players and the community. More than just quality medical education, we are a world-class research center. That's why our alumni are our pride. Their achievements are our crowning glory. Together, we celebrate 10 years of quality medical education. Together, we journey towards an illustrious future. The Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences, Monash University, Malaysia. Since 2007, the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences at Monash University, Malaysia has nurtured thousands of medical students. 8 batches of students have embarked on this noble journey to transform lives. It has been 10 glorious years. Our students and graduates' heartwarming recollections are articulated in On Becoming a Doctor. Experience their moments, share their emotions. Walk with them through their most precious memories. If you inspire to take up medicine, this book offers you insights to the journey. If you are already on this journey, the anecdotes will resonate with you. At the Jeffrey Cheah School of Medicine and Health Sciences at Monash University, Malaysia, we believe in providing holistic medical education, producing graduates who are reflective and compassionate. On Becoming a Doctor is a testament to these ideals. Enjoy the book.
Thank you very much, the Honourable Minister and the Country for the launch of the books and signing the book. Thank you very much for launching our books and signing the plaque. We now ask you to just enjoy your dinner. There will be some entertainment provided by some more dancers and of course the Monash Chamber Orchestra. Enjoy the rest of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you've enjoyed the food so far. The last bit of entertainment for this evening are the Monash University Malaysia dance troupe calling themselves the Street Performers. Please enjoy their performance.
Oh, is yours. The world is yours. Till I'm charged and writing in my book of rhymes, all the words past the margin. The whole of mic I'm throbbing, mechanical movement, understandable smooth shit that murderers move with. The thief sting, clicking at night, they won't act right. The feet of hip hop has got me stuck like a crack pipe. The mind activation, react like I'm facing time like Pappy Mason. With pins I'm embracing, wipe the sweat off my dome, spit the phlegm on the streets. Sway Tim's on my beats, makes my cycle complete. Weather cruising in the six cab, I'm on terror deep, I can't call it. The beats make me falling asleep, I keep falling. But never falling 6 feet deep. I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Say what?
I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Say what?
I'm out for dead presidents to represent me.
Whose world is this?
The world is yours.
His presence here today, and of course very honoured by the presence of our founder, Tun Sri Geoffrey Cheah. And let me also acknowledge the Australian, as a good Australian, I must acknowledge the Australian High Commissioner here, and I think it's one feature of the success of this medical school that I'd like to comment on. And the presence of the Malaysian Minister of Health here and the Australian High Commissioner really symbolises that this is a fantastic achievement in transnational cooperation in higher education. You know, Australia and Malaysia... Australia and Malaysia have a strong relationship that goes back many years. Monash Malaysia's presence here in this wonderful partnership with the Sunway Group is a sign of that broader strength of relationship between Malaysia and Australia, and the medical school in particular really underlines the vibrancy and strength of that transnational relationship. So thank you very much to the Minister who's just left us. Thank you very much, Rod, the Australian High Commissioner, for joining us this evening. Thank you all very much. Good night. What a wonderful celebration of 10 years. I've only been here since January, but I am delighted to celebrate and take a fair bit of credit for this wonderful 10 years of achievement. So thank you all very much indeed.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen. For those who are still young, the night is still young.